So.
Yes. Before we start discussing this, let us first talk about what is called the Hilbert transform. Note that the Hilbert transform is different from the Fourier transform or the Laplace transform. In the form, it's not a transform per se, but rather a function. So, or rather a convolution operation. So, consider consider or consider a filter. Filter with an impulse response HT. Fine, consider a filter with an impulse response HT such that HT now, based on this, from the properties of Fourier transform, we know that HF will simply be signum function or signum function of F whose Fourier transform is J for F less than 0, 0 for F equal to 0 and minus J or 1 over J for F greater than 0. Fine. So basically when we so this HT gives us this Fourier transform. Now for any other signal XT, X hat T is called its Hilbert transform when X hat T equals XT convolved with HT. Fine. And consequently, X hat F equals HF XF equals J XF F less than 0, 0 F equal to 0 minus J XF F greater than 0. Fine. So this. So X hat F gets phase shifted by 90 degrees when F less than 0. It reduces to 0 when F equal to 0 and X hat F gets phase shifted by 270 degrees or minus 90 degrees, whatever you want to call it, when F fine. So now let us define another signal. Let's call it x dot t equals xt plus j x hat t. Consequently, by the linearity of Fourier transform, x hat x dot f equals xf plus j x hat f equals xf plus minus xf 0. So I should put a half here. Yes, to make life simple, I should put a half everywhere. Half. So 0 and xf. Fine. This equals half, or rather, this equals 0 f less than 0, xf or x0 by 2 f equal to 0, and xf when f greater than 0. Or what I am essentially doing is this x dot f is doing nothing but, so x dot f is suppressing all the negative frequencies of the signal. Consequently, if this minus w to w, so if this is x of f, then dot f simply becomes the right hand side, or we suppress the negative frequencies. This now let's see what happens when, so x dot f contains only positive frequencies. Fine. Now let's see what happens when we take x dot t cos, or rather x dot t e to the power j 2 pi f c t. So fine. This is a Fourier transform pair, and FC plus W. Fine, so 0. So I get a single sideband that has been shifted in the frequency, but we also know that x dot t j 2 pi fct equals xt plus half xt plus j x hat t cos 2 pi fct plus j sin 2 pi ct. Fine. So this becomes xt cos 2 pi fct minus sine 2 pi fct plus j xt cos 2 pi fct plus x hat t, sorry, x hat t cos 2 pi fct plus xt sin 2 pi fct. If we take the real part of this thing, if we take just the real part of t, then So let's call this as check of t. Is this then again from the Fourier properties of Fourier transform, x fc plus w minus fc minus w. So this is a single sideband modulated AM signal. So this is how we generate SSB using the properties of Hilbert transform.